Georgia, the Georgia Dome, the site of the SEC tournament. As the Kentucky and Alabama fans roll in, we've got four teams remaining on semifinal Saturday. Game one, the Tide and the Wildcats. The first of two here in the Peach State and the capital of the South.
Get to the front of the rim. Nice lob. Harrelson all alone from Jones. I don't know where the defense was there, but it wasn't on Josh Harrelson. He's talking to him over there on the Kentucky bench. Here's Lamb from three-point land. Got it.
The shooting background here doesn't bother Jordan Lamb. He is dialed in.
Three. Harrelson kept it alive by just swatting it out there to Lamb. And Lamb knocks down the jumper.
Brad, best part of his game is the middle game out of Jordan Lamb. He shoots.
Lamb inside with a finger roll.
Again, Brad, that's his A game. Ran him off of a tight curl. You see the little hesitation and the change of speed.
Really backed off of their man. Pressure for Alabama. Club, like you said, that only makes about four threes per game. Ooh, Harrelson just smothered that would-be shot in the game so far. Seven on the shot clock. Lamb's going to take another one. Get another one.
Brad, you cannot run a circle cut off of a screener any better than what Jordan Lamb just did. He went 360 degrees around the screener. To Reggie Miller from the 10 straight points for Jordan Lamb.
Rutherford again rejected by Harrelson, a second block shot. Here the Kentucky Blue come to life. Why not? Their sensational freshmen are playing pretty well, including Deron Lamb. 10 straight points. He's got the eyes, got the threes.
Zone out the timeout.
Liggins will try three. Boy, everything's working right now for Kentucky. Well, Liggins, and he's one of the poorer shooting three-point. Darius Miller, bounce pass to Liggins is a beauty.
But don't fight pressure with pressure. And that's what Kentucky.
Darius Miller trying to back in on Hillman in the paint. And that's a money shot right there for Darius Miller. He does that as well as anybody.
That's a money shot.
Liggins works around Hillman. And good looking move by DeAndre Liggins.
Talked about Alabama's defense, Brad. Very good at pressuring the band. He goes right at the hip of Scenario Hillman. That's going through pressure instead of around pressure. And results in a strong two-handed basket by DeAndre Liggins. You don't power drive and finesse.
Jumper in and out. Harrelson, another offensive rebound, and he scores it in close.
What are you doing out of time at the same time?
First and last, huh?
He's done well.
Miller, long ball, got it. Darius Miller adding to the three-point barrage by Kentucky. And now they're up by top.
It makes it very difficult to come back from.
Jones lost the handle. Harrelson, who else, picks it up and scores.
Right place, right time, and has really good hands. For a guy his size, Brad, to go down and snatch a basketball below his knees.
Darius Miller getting in the three-point act as Kentucky's knocked down four here in the first half, and their lead is stretched to 14. Guarding Harrelson that far away in the basket. Again, he's got two fouls, and he doesn't need a third, or Anthony Grant's going to have some real issues to deal with. Darius Miller turn around off the window.
And that was a patient play by Darius Miller because Hankerson, you talk about timeouts. Critical part of the game in March.
Darius Jones throws one down.
It was a brick. And they still have a big lead.
Miller to Harrelson. Harrelson's got 10. Knight, he'll take a three. And got it.
Yeah, he's so good. Catching the ball. Going either direction into a shot. That's unique for a young player.
Time to go in the ball game.
And when this guy has that release, rotation, and result, the Kentucky.
Vanderbilt in the second semifinal game today. Knight again with a quick release three.
How good can you be out of timeouts in the semifinal?
As the play. And it's Knight on a cut to the basket.
They'll run that about two, maybe three times a game where Brandon Knight will throw to the.
Knight again around a low block screen. He's got 10 straight like Lamb had in the first half. Putting on a show, a clinic right now for Brandon Knight. It's a 21-point Kentucky lead. And now everybody wearing blue at
the Georgia Dome, including an Elvis wannabe on their feet. Kentucky by 21.
Look at what I just drew. Bam, look at the back screen by Jones. Freeze him up. Alabama not pressuring the basketball. John Calipari sees it. Four.
Brandon West got 10 of Kentucky's 14 in this half. Here's a steal by Terrence Jones. Length of the court. Kentucky by 23.
He's going to accept a screen.
Liggins wide open. Knocks it down. DeAndre Liggins, second three of the afternoon. A game that they have got in hand right now, unless Alabama makes a serious run at him. Harrelson drives and lays it in. The big fella rumbles down the paint. He's got 12. Tom, his third. Terrence Jones running the court, flushing it down. Kentucky runs out to a 23-point lead in the SEC tournament on ABC. We'll continue after this message.
We don't always describe Florida as a grinded-type team, but they can this year with that size.
Brandon Knight, quick release. Josh Harrelson with a step back.
You know what? You love the shot by Knight because it's close to the middle third of the floor. For the reason
Bob Wiggins both.
You know, it's hard to stay away from team colors. Everybody gives us grief about that. Liggins for three.
Brad, I'm not sure you can be any better out of a timeout today than Kentucky's been. That's their 19th point.
And Charvez Davis playing for the steal. It's Lamb over Jamichael Green. It goes, and he's fouled.
Deron Lamb and Brandon Knight have gotten so much better at absorbing contact around the rim 4 or 5 months ago, but not now. Watch Deron Lamb. And because he's 6'4", and see how high his release is. He takes the contact, but watch the release point. As high as he can get it with long arms and kisses it at top third.
A lot of teams with a 21-point lead would say, okay, 4 minutes left, let's get some other guys some time and get these guys some rest. There's nobody in there that they can put in that are as good as the ones they have to rest him. And Miller knocks down another three. He's in double figures. And people say, well, you know, we're Kentucky. We like winning crowns here. Well, they might win another one, but they might do it shorthanded tomorrow. Because question marks now. There was no question about who was going to win this game. The question marks lie now in the health of the Wildcats. They'll play in the SEC title game tomorrow against either Florida or Vanderbilt as they run away from Alabama, 72-56. But again, the fans in here and the majority are decked out in Kentucky blue, have big question marks on the expressions on their faces as to how healthy will the Wildcats be for that one tomorrow.